Well, dealing with live explosives isn't something that many folks would volunteer to do. But for the members of the Midland Police Department Bomb Squad, it's just part of the job.
And as you know, we've had some recent scares here in the Tall City. Gina Martinez went inside the squad's local training center to give you a look at what they do every time they're out on a call.
You see it on TV and in the movies, but for these guys, there are no special effects. The Midland Police Department Bomb Squad is a small but strong force of sharply trained men who volunteer their time. The squad is made up of just three members covering 17 counties. Brian Rayco is the sergeant.
Our decisions are made for life protection first, property second. And that's the way it goes.
The squad averages about two calls a month. Three calls came in just in the last few weeks when a Stripes convenience store was targeted twice in as many days. Then there was the backpack scare last week at Midland Park Mall.
We consider every single one of them an actual event until we prove it otherwise.
And just how do they do that? Well, we went to see for ourselves.
Right now I'm getting suited up in the search suit. It weighs about 80 pounds. This is actually a little bit lighter than what they normally wear. We're told those regular search suits are about 100 pounds.
We went outside for a basic drill. A suspicious package has been found and needs to be x-rayed.
It's pretty heavy. You can tell I'm already breathing a little bit hard. We're just walking across the field and it's getting pretty hot and it's breezy out here right now. So you can just imagine what these guys go through every time they go out on a call.
Next, the squad brings the x-ray film inside to be scanned. And the image is displayed on monitors.
That's your basic drill. If everything else goes wrong, that's what we have to do. We do have to get in the suits and go down range and x-ray suspicious packages.
The squad's robot performed these during the Midland Park Mall incident.
It ended up being a jewelry box. There were some circuit boards and watches and stuff like that inside there. We don't know if it was a person might have been homeless, left their backpack.
But it's not just suspicious packages or bomb threats. The guys are even called to help out local oil companies who make shocking discoveries. Sergeant Rayco says parts of the basin used to be a bombing range back in World War II.
There are still rounds out there, duds, trainers, or actual explosives.
But it's nothing the bomb squad can't handle. Reporting in Midland, Gina Martinez, NewsWest 9.